So before we let Dr. Phil go, we wanted to ask him about entitlement culture in this nation and what it means for us. And boy, did he have a prime example for us. Watch this. Tomorrow you have a show, and it taps right into some of the things we've been discussing on The Kelly File, which is this culture of fame, of narcissism, of obsessed with the camera, and what are you going to do for me? How is it all about me? And you introduce us to a lovely man by the name of Chris. Tell us a little bit about him before we show him a clip.
This is a perfect example, and this is the reason I'm doing this, because we do have a generation that I think we have raised with a great degree of entitlement, where it's like, the world owes me a living. And we picked a perfect example story of a kid that says, I want to be a rock star. I say, kid, he's now 40 years old. Mm-hmm. I want to be a rock star. And has basically tried to buy fame, has bled his family, his mother and father, for $1.7 million. Oh, $1.7 million trying to be a rock star. I mean, he's got the poses, he's got the haircut, he's got everything, but so entitled that he won't take a job because it's not rock star job. And it is just such a poser. And it got to the point where he said, my God is Kiss. My God is Gene Simmons. So I said, you know what? He's a friend of mine. I'm going to bring him on here and let him talk to you about what it takes to get to fame. Because it's not what you think. It's not all bright lights and
right. And when you get there, it's not all bright lights either. I want to introduce the audience to Chris, who's apparently on his way. Watch.
How many women have you had carnal knowledge of?
I don't know, 400 or 500.
Is that part of the rock star lifestyle?
Yeah, that's part of the whole love them and leave them, the persona. Fast cars and beautiful women. So I'm like, I can play the drums and I can play the guitar. I want everybody to come and love it all.
You know, you're such a jerk.
Yeah, well.
Sorry.
I might be a little narcissistic.
You're living with your mother.
Well, yeah, I like to put a spin on everything. Sometimes it's a little bit too much frosting and you need a little bit more cake.
What the hell are you talking about?
You don't understand the rock lingo?
Yeah, I just threw up on my mouth a little bit.
You're living with your mother.
I mean, this guy's a rock star, right? I mean, he's got all the poses, got all these guitars. He's living on a twin bed in his mother's house.
Oh, ladies, I mean, take note.
Yeah.
When you get spun by a character like this in a bar, the reality is probably that.
You're going home to mama's house.
Yeah, if he wants to go back to your place, there's a reason.
Yeah.
Take it from Dr. Phil.
Yeah, let's go to your house because mine doesn't exist.
What is the bottom line? What do people need to remember? I mean, it's... Because I meet these people all the time. I don't know how to suck them out of that place. I don't know how to get them out of that dark place.
You know, when you look at America, people sometimes ask me, you know, what's wrong with America? Look, this is the greatest country in the world. It's the greatest people in the world. But sometimes we forget common sense, just simple things that we need to remember. Like, basically, you just don't reward bad behavior. Just think about that. How commonsensical is that? Just do not reward bad behavior.
His mom seemed like a sensible lady.
Now,
how did she wind up with him?
She needed to figure that out $1.7 million ago. Now she says you are a jerk when she spent all of her retirement money, all of her future. These people are going to have to sell their house and go to work at 70 years old because they've let this ridiculous, entitled kid bleed them of all their retirement and all their security in their autumn years. We've got to stop rewarding bad behavior in America. When people don't work and produce, then they need to get kicked to the curb, get a damn job, carry your own weight. It's just that simple. We need accountability. Stop rewarding bad behavior, hold people accountable, make them carry their own weight. It's just that simple.
Amen, Dr. Phil.
Amen.
Love that brand of common sense wisdom. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.